In this problem, we want to determine what is the departure function if we have a fluid that's modeled by the simple van der Waals equation state. So the van der Waals equation state has two constants, B, which is accounting for the fact that molecules occupy some volume, whereas in ideal gas, they occupy zero volume, and A, which accounts for interactions between molecules. Attractive forces can change then the pressure compared to an ideal gas. So we want to use this van der Waals equation state, and we're going to use the departure function equation that is from Elliott and Lira. It relates the enthalpy at the for a real gas minus the enthalpy if it were an ideal gas, and we dimensionalize it by dividing by RT. It's equal to the integral between zero and rho, where rho is the density, minus the temperature, the partial of z respect to temperature at constant rho, and z is the compressibility factor, and we'll talk more about that. And then the derivative of density over density plus z minus 1. So we want to be able to determine z for this equation of state, and then do this differentiation, then do this integration. So z is the compressibility factor. It's defined as PV over RT. So I can take this equation state, divide by RT, multiply by V, and I'm going to end up with Z equal to volume. Volume minus this constant, minus A over VR. So I have the compressibility factor for van der Waals equation state. I'm going to do one more division because I eventually want this in terms of density. So I'm going to divide through by V here, and I'll leave this the same. And now I'm going to substitute in terms of density. Density is 1 over V because this is a specific volume. This is cubic meters per mole, for example. And so the inverse is density. So the compressibility factor in terms of density is 1 over 1 minus B times the density minus A times the density over RT. So now I can do this differentiation. The partial derivative of Z respect to T, temperature, holding the density constant. Well, the first term, density is constant, B is a constant, so the derivative is zero. Second term, A is a constant, density is a constant, R is a constant, so I'm differentiating 1 over T, and I end up with minus 1 over T squared, which is constant times the density over RT squared. So now I'm going to substitute this partial derivative back into this integral equation that allows me to calculate the departure function. So departure function divided by RT, integral from zero to density, minus T times this partial derivative, times the differential of density divided by density, plus Z minus 1. You can see this T cancels, this density cancels. So this equation just reduces to this. And this integration then, A is a constant, R and T are independent of rho. So I just end up with a minus sign. And the integral of d rho is just rho between limits. So rho minus zero, the limits. And now I'll substitute in my Z in terms of the van der Waals equation state in density. And then I have the minus one. So now I combine the first term with this next to last term, and then I have this term, and then the one I'm just going to write this way to allow me to simplify and end up with the departure function 2 times the constant times density over RT plus constant density over 1 minus B times the density. So this is the dimensionless departure function, and then I've also converted it back into specific volume. So departure function is related to the volume, the temperature, and these constants, and it's clearly non-zero for a van der Waals equation of state.